This problem demonstrates a force on a submerged surface, which makes what makes this a little bit different is instead of having atmospheric at the pressure at the top of our liquid, we actually have a pressure of 100 pound force per foot squared. So the best way is to do a free body diagram. So we're going to look at this door and look at the forces on it. And there are a couple of ways to do it, but I think the easiest way to do this is to break this up and first look at the force of the water on the door, as well as the force from the pressure at the top of the surface. So let's first look at the force from the water, and we know that that's going to be a resultant force that we can calculate, and that is going to be located at y sub r. The next thing is we're going to look at this force from the pressure that's given, and because it's uniform, it's going to be acting at L over 2, where L is the length of this door, which is 3 feet. Okay, so the first thing we're going to do, our governing equation, is that the sum of the moments equal 0. So how do we write that out? Well, it's the force, resultant force because of the water, times L minus y sub r, because that's where the lever arm is going to be, plus the force of the pressure times L minus L over 2 is going to equal the force on the door times L, where again L is the lever arm. And what I mean by the lever arm, and if you look at these, the lever arm is the distance between where the force is acting, or the resultant force, and the hinge. So let's start by solving for FR, which is our gamma H sub C A. Our gamma is given as 100 pound force per feet cubed. Our H sub C, which is just the centroid, and this is just a rectangle, is halfway down, or 1.5 feet. And our area is 6 feet squared. So our F sub R is 900 pound force. Next, let's calculate our y sub r, which is this I sub xc divided by h sub c times a plus y over c. And if you remember, because of water and how it changes as you go down, y sub r is always going to be larger than y sub c. So we have to go into our book to find the equation to figure out I sub xc. And for a rectangle, it's 1/12 times b times a cubed, which is 1/12. What's our b? Well, our b is our horizontal length, which is 2. Our a is our vertical, which is 3. Cubed. And so our I sub xc is 4.5 feet to the fourth. So let's put that back in to figure out y sub r. So that's 4.5 feet to the fourth divided by 1.5 feet. Again, that's our h sub c times our area of that door, which is 6 feet squared, and we add to that y sub c, which is the same as x sub c, which is 1.5 feet. So our y sub r is 2 feet. Again, our L is 3 feet. So now it's just a matter of putting our force of the door, we're going to go back to our original equation, equals 900 pounds force, which was our F sub R that we calculated, L minus Y sub R plus, what's the force of the pressure that is placed or applied to the free surface? Well, that's 100 pound force divided by foot squared times its area, because force is pressure times area, which is 6 feet squared, times L over 2, which is 1.5 feet. And this is all divided by the lever arm for the force on the door, which is L, or 3 feet. So the force that's necessary to keep the door closed because of the force of the water and the applied pressure is 600 pound force.